Coming to the next problem, for the circuit shown in figure, find the current I4 using the superposition theorem, right? Superposition theorem, right? The current I4 means the current passes through the 4 ohms. The current passes through the 4 ohms resistance, right? Okay, you said that is he has given superposition means you should consider that first of all here how many number of sources given in the circuit, right? So the number of sources in the circuit is only two, right? 220 voltage source one and 5 amperes current source, right? Number of voltage sources plus current source, and that is number of sources, right? Number of sources means here only two, right? You should not consider as that is dependent source. Dependent source should not be considered and also should not disturb also like resistance position, right? Here the number of volts, the number of sources are two, and the number of steps in superposition theorem also two only, right? Step one means 20 voltage source acting alone. 20 voltage source acting alone, right? So while the current source is inactive, means it should be open circuited, right? This is open circuited. You see that the step one here, 20 voltage source acting alone. 20 voltage source acting alone, right? Then the 20 voltage source acting alone, the circuit becomes like this. Okay, here the current source is open circuited, right? This is the current source here. The position of current source is open circuited, right? Okay, we have to find out that is I4 means, let us say in the first case I currently consider as a IX, and the second case I consider as a current as IY. Okay, right? First circuit, that is apply the mesh analysis, right? So then the current IX, let the current IX position that in this way, okay? The current passes through in this way, right? So first it touches the minus, right? Minus 20 plus 4 into IX, right? Then the current passes through in this way and this way, plus 2 into IX. Next, plus here it touches plus only, plus 2 into IX equals 0, right? Simply we can determine that is he has given that I4 in the circuit, he has given that I4 2 into I4, but particularly I mentioned that IX because I4 is equal to IX only, because I4 and means the current passes through the 4 ohms. Here also the current passes through the 4 ohms is IX only, and because it has only one current and one loop only, okay? Now that is IX passes through this way and this way and this way, like this, okay? The current passes through all the term, that is the all the parameters is only IX, right? The I4 means here consider as a IX only, IX equal to I4, right? IX equal to I4. That's why I mentioned that 2 into I4 means 2 into IX. That's why I'm here. I put it as 2 into I4 in place, that is I 2 into IX only equal to 0, right? So from this, we simplify this equation, that is IX equal to 20/8, which is equal to 0.5 amperes. That is IX. In the second case, right? So coming to the step two. Step two means that is 5 ampere source. Right? Is 5 ampere source acting alone while the 20 volt source is inactive. The voltage source means short circuited. Right? Short circuited. The circuit becomes like this. Okay? The circuit becomes like this. Okay? The voltage source is short circuited here. Okay, then here we use simply nodal analysis. Okay, nodal analysis means let the voltage at this node is V. Okay, let this the voltage at this point is V. Okay, the current passes through the 4 ohms here. Actually, I4 means IY. Okay, I4 means IY. Okay, and because the current passes through this way is I4, I mentioned actually in the given problem, but I mentioned that IY. Okay, right. Here which is equal to V, for the equation becomes, so not from the node analysis, V/4, first current V/4 plus here the current passes so towards the node, away from the node, right? Towards the node means minus 5, right? Okay, minus 5. The next to V minus 2 into IY/2 v minus 2 into iy by 2, right? Because this is the voltage and this is the voltage, right? Both are voltage only. That is the current. We need current, right? The current passes through this branch means potential difference between the two branches divided by the resistance. Potential difference means v minus 2 into iy by 2. V minus 2 into iy by 2, right? So v by 4 plus minus 5 amp minus 5 v minus 2 into iy by 2, right? So from this I4 means iy only, right? Iy plus, okay, na? Right. So simplify this equation. First of all, here we have two unknown parameters, v and iy, right? So first of all, iy, what is meant by iy? Iy means the current passes through the 4 ohms. Also, okay, now the current passes of 4 ohms, and also the current IY is towards the node, right? But we mentioned that the current is V by 4, right? So we can mention the IY is equal to V by 4. That is V by 4 means minus V by 4. Because the current, I mentioned that the current voltage at this point is higher than this one. But he has given that direction, okay? Na? In the problem, he has given. But I mentioned that voltage V is greater than the any other voltages according to nodal analysis, right? V divided by 4, but mentioned IY is in opposite direction, that IY equal to minus V by 4, right? So put IY value in this equation, that is minus V by 4, right? V by 4 minus 5 plus V by 2 minus 2 into IY means minus V by 4. Right, simplify this equation. From this, we can get as V equal to 5 volts. Right, so from this, we need IY value. IY equal to minus V by 4 minus V. V means 5 volts minus 5 by 4. Right, so from this, IY equal to minus 5 by 4, which is equal to minus 1.25 amperes. From this, total current I4 equal to Ix plus IY. According to superposition theorem, total current I4, that is I4 equal to, that is he has asked that is I4 value, right? I4 value means first case Ix and second case IY, right? First case Ix value and second case IY value. So the according to superposition, total current I4 equal to Ix plus I4. Then we can get as 1.25 amperes. Okay, right? Thank you.